Hello folks, today's guide is all about digital gardening, helping you to understand what it is and how you can apply it to your own productivity. Digital gardening is best explained by Anne Law of Nest Labs. A digital garden is an online space at the intersection of a notebook and a blog, where digital gardeners share seeds of thoughts to be cultivated in public. This has been a really popular trend in 2020, as people learning begin to share what they have learnt to the wider web. These methods have been embraced by folks like Tiago Forte, as someone who always shares his learning as taught in Second Brain as part of the learning process. So basically, digital gardening is just a way to express your learning and help others learn. But unlike traditional blogs, they can be updated and upgraded to further continue their learning, much like gardens. Gardens that have plants that need tending to, and once a plant has been tended to, it'll grow stronger once constantly spruced. Digital gardens can be crafted using many different tools. The no-code era has definitely made it easier, and tools like Notion, Roam, Obsidian, and some of the other wiki tools are very popular as they require very little servicing. This is mainly due to bidirectional links, which help you to connect thoughts together in a digital garden and offer the learner and end learner a deeper, more embedded way of learning. A much more pruned example of a digital garden is the one presented by Maggie Appleton, who shares insights on the learning and even categorizes them based on their stage of fruition. Digital gardening is growing and something you can embrace today. Quite easy to set up a digital garden and something that you can do for anything you're learning at the moment. As we look inwards, the benefits of reflection and learning can help others and not just yourself. Something we always thought was reserved for creators. So hopefully this explained digital gardening to you guys, and hope you enjoy more Keep Productive videos, so please do make sure you're subscribed. Thank you very much.